What's going on, everyone? Now, Refraction. Before we start, I did not mention on the notes, but refraction applies to sun waves as well. It's not reserved for light only. Again, refraction happens with sound as well. Don't forget that, okay? However, our example is going to deal with optics, light. Okay, it says, the sketch to the right shows a light ray moving from air into water at 45 degrees to the normal. Three questions. One, which of the three rays indicated with capital letters is most likely the light ray that continues inside the water? Two, calculate the angle to question one. And three, calculate the velocity of light in water. Okay, the first one, although it seems to be the simplest one, I personally would start with question two, and you'll see why. But let's start with question one, okay? Let me go ahead and select this one. Perfect. Now, let's eliminate ray B. The reason why is look at the incident ray, and then ray B is just a continuation of the incident ray, meaning nothing happened to the ray. That means it was not refracted. It was not bent towards any direction whatsoever. Therefore, we can be sure B is not the answer. However, I'm going to use B as a reference line, you could call it, because this angle is 45 degrees. And if ray B is a continuation of this incident ray, this angle over here from the surface of the water to ray B is 45 degrees. And the angle from the normal line to ray B is also 45 degrees, okay? It'll be a reference line. Very good. Now, what if you don't know? It could be A, could be C. That's why I would start with a question two, which says, calculate the angle to question one. And to do that, we're going to use Snell's law. But before we do that, you know what? No, let's write Snell's law. That'll help us with the given. So Snell's law. Let me write it over here. Snell's law. It said N1 sine theta 1 is equal to N2 sine theta 2. So we need two angles, and then we need index of refraction for air and water. Now let me go to the note so you can see I provided those two. Index of refraction for air is 1.00. Index of refraction for water is 1.33. Okay, so let's write our given. So given, we have N1, index of refraction for air, 1.00. Theta 1, which is the incident angle, we're told is 45 degrees. So theta 1 is equal to 45 degrees. Index of refraction for water, 1.33. We're looking for theta 2. The angle of refraction. Okay. Before we substitute, let's do some algebra and you'll see why. We need theta 2. First step would be divide both sides by N2. Because we're trying to isolate theta 2. These two cancel. Our equation looks like and 1 sine theta 1 is equal to, N1 sine theta 1 divided by N2 is equal to sine theta 2. Now substitute, you'll see why. N1, index of refraction for air is 1.00, times sine of theta 1, that angle is 45 degrees. We're going to divide by N2, index of refraction of water, that is 1.33. This is equal to sine theta 2. I'm going to move this over here. Let's do it. I'm going to use parentheses because this top portion is one operation. So 1 times sine, so trig functions, now before you do anything else, make sure your setup is on degrees, not radians. So you want it to be DEG, not RAD. Okay? And we're going to divide this whole thing by 1.33. Press enter. We have 0.531. Okay? Don't forget that. 0.531. Okay. So let me write it over here. Sine theta 2 is equal to 0.531. What do you do next? You don't divide by sine. You're going to take the inverse function of sine, which is, just for simplicity, because this is high school level, we're going to call it sine to the negative 1. So it'll look like this. Theta 2 is equal to inverse sine function, so sine to the negative 1 of 0.531. So let's do that. Trig functions. You'll see it. Sine to the negative 1. Instead of writing 0.531, I'm just going to select my previous answer by control ANS for answer. Press enter. 32.11. I'm just going to round to 32 degrees, okay? Theta 2 is equal to 32 degrees. So I'm going to write my answers in blue. Theta 2 is equal to 32 degrees. This is my angle of refraction. Okay. Now, how to use this angle? Don't forget that we're going to measure the angles from the normal, not the surface of the water. Because if you do that, if you measure from the surface, then you're going to get the wrong answer, of course. Let us recall that this angle from normal to ray B is 45 degrees. Now, ray A cannot be the answer because this is more than 45 degrees. If we measure the angle from normal to A, it's like maybe 60 around there. And then C, notice it's before ray B, so it is less than 45 degrees. That's the only one that could be 32. So this is 32 degrees. Therefore, the answer is C. So we write it down. Ray C. Now the final one, calculate the velocity of light in water. On the notes, I gave you the equation solved for velocity, and you know, when we have index of refraction. But if you were to look it up in the textbook, you'll find it differently. And I'm going to do the, it's a very simple algebra step. Okay, so let's go back to purple. the equation that you're going to find when you look like on the internet or textbooks is index of refraction is equal to speed of light divided by velocity. And we want to solve for V. So we multiply both sides by V. These two cancel. We have velocity. Let me start over. This is not C. This is N for index of refraction. Okay? So V times N is equal to speed of light. Now, we want V by itself. We divide by N. Let's redo this line. These two cancel. And you have velocity is equal to speed of light divided by index of refraction. This lowercase c is speed of light in vacuum, but we're going to use the same number, okay, for simplicity. 3.0 times 10 to the 8 meters per second. So let's substitute 3.0 times 10 to the 8 meters per second. We're going to divide by 1.33 because that's the index of refraction in water. We want the velocity or speed of light in water. So let's do that one now. Parentheses 3. Don't forget that instead of times 10, we use double E function. 8. We're going to divide by 1.33. And disregard that email. The answer is 2.25 times 10 to the 8th power meters per second. So let's write it down in blue. So speed of light in water, so I'm just going to add a W, is equal to 2.25 times 10 to the 8th power meters per second. Do not forget about the units. There you go, that's all right. And that's it. Simple problem. Don't forget, we measure angles from the normal. Okay? See ya.